brief moment here until Nipissing will have the man advantage. McLeisier out there, number 9, along with Tardif Richard, number 8. And here comes McGill. Up ahead, Tardif Richard up the ice, into the corner it goes. Dion fighting for it with Tardif Richard behind the net. Comes back out, and Nipissing will have the power play in 16 seconds. Colin Campbell, starting pass. No one there for Nipissing. And right now, they have not been able to get good puck possession inside the Redmen zone. And Nipissing will be on the power play in 3 seconds from now. We'll have the advantage for about a minute and 19 seconds here in the first period. 14 minutes left in the first period. Puck kept in. McGill applying more pressure than Nipissing would have envisioned right now. And they still can't get puck possession. Finally comes up to Colin Campbell, number 89, over into McGill territory. Beyond the pass, 2. And here comes Nipissing setting up their power play. Campbell loses the handle briefly to Bailey. Back up. Back over to Bailey. Robichaud, my apologies. Down low to Bailey, number 27, being harassed. McGill applying great pressure, and they'll clear the puck away. A good job by the McGill Redmen penalty kill.
Yes, yeah, nice job, as you said, right there by the penalty kill from McGill. Coming up for change right now. Here we see big number 28, Patrick Delahue, coming off for the penalty kill. Let's see if he can make something happen for the Redmen.
Up ahead now is Bailey being harassed, and it'll be cleared once again by the McGill defense, led by Hugo Lapal, who clears it away. McDowell can't keep it in. And away comes Nipissing. And McGill doing a great job, led by Laporte, and whistle call offside on the play here. And right now, McGill is held serve with their penalty kill. And in fact, it seemed like McGill was on the power play, even though they're on the penalty kill.
But that's exactly it. If you look who was on that previous shift there, right there on the power play, I mentioned number 28, Patrick Delahoud, obviously number 11 as well, Cedric McNichol. So it's rare, you know, for some teams to put the top players on the penalty kill, but as you can see right now, the Redmen aren't afraid to do that, and it's leading to some offensive chances for them.
3 seconds left on the power play for Nipissing, and McGill will be back to even strength. Wide of the net is shot by Smith. Behind the net he goes. Big hit by LeMay. Couldn't make contact with Smith behind the net. Todd Harvey, number 19. Centering pass, no one there. Matthew Pompey up ahead. Here comes Pompano. Breakaway shoots. Good save by Refuse, and Matthew Pompey will retrieve it. Trying to send it to Neil Prokop, who couldn't get to it, and Gervais Chouinard will get it back. And McGill will reset as Nipissing will make a line change and bring out some new forwards out there. Prokop, number 21, can't keep it in. Here comes Craig Campbell. Down the left wing line, shoots. Saved by Gervais Chouinard. An easy save for him as he makes another start for the McGill Redmen. He's the guy that played well in the playoffs last year, Brent. How important will he be this year?
Well, he'll be very important. I actually had a chance to speak to the coach, Kelly Gnomes, last night, and he said one of the keys to the season is going to be the team's goaltending, and obviously it starts right there with number 30, Jacob Gervais Renard. Obviously, right now he came up with a big save, so McGill's going to definitely need him to do a lot more of that as this game goes on.
Simon Tadlet-Richard taking the faceoff against Morrison of Nipissing. Won by Nipissing. Morrison now being hounded by Laporte. Back to the point it goes. Cleared away and back into Nipissing territory, and Gleason will go and recover it as we approach the 12:50 mark here in the first period. Nipissing up ahead now is Campbell. Big hit. Brunel recovers it. Over the blue line he goes. One on two. Can't get around the two blue shirts, and he'll go in the corner. Brunel back to Laporte. Rink wide pass. Shot. Blocked and saved by Refuse. And right now, McGill has controlled the tempo in the last 5 minutes here. If you are Nipissing, what can you do to regain that momentum, as right now McGill has been all over the place with the puck, attacking their end?
Well, what they got to do is, first off, when they have the puck in their zone, they're trying to get it out. They got to make a smart outlet pass. One of the problems right now is McGill's pressing really hard with that forecheck, and the Nipissing defenders, some of them are making bad passes or bad plays with the puck, and they're creating turnovers, basically. So I think the Lakers need to settle down right now. It's early in the game still. They're down 1-0, but it's still early in the game. Just under 12 minutes left in the first period. So it's got to settle down and take the game as it comes to them.
Number one line out there for McGill. Cedric McNichol, David Rose, and Patrick Delahoud. Back to the point it goes. Boutte over to Rose. Back to Boutte. He's got space to work with. He'll pass it over now. Poulin shoots. Screenshot. Loose puck. Rebound. McGill retains it. Shoots again by McNichol. Can't get to it, and it's cleared away as Boutte will recover. Good pressure by the Redmen on that faceoff draw won by McGill. almost scoring on that opportunity. Patton can't clear it away. McNichol waiting for the offside player to come back onside.
You see the Redmen right there. The Redmen are clogging up the neutral zone a little bit, forcing the forwards for the Lakers to have to pinch back a bit on defense, and right now it's causing another turnover.
Center pass scores. And it appears it went off the Nipissing player. We'll get the official goal score. But Cedric McNichol makes it 2-0 for the McGill Redmen.
See, there you go. There you go right there, Maude. Like I was just saying, there's a turnover around the neutral zone area. McGill was able to pick it up and put the puck in the back in an effort. 2-0 lead.
2-0 lead for McGill. We'll get the official goal score. Cedric McNichol, center of the pass. May have gone off a Nipissing player. We'll get the exact call as we're less than 10 minutes into the first period. Already a 2-0 lead here for the Redmen. Face-off won by Nipissing.
His first of the season, scored by number 11, Cedric Nipissing. Assisted by number 7, David Rose.
So Rose gets the assist, and McNichol will get the goal off a Nipissing player. His first goal of the year. 3 assists already this season, 4 points for the year. Pompey can't get the shot off, and is saved by Kirk Refuse. And right now, McGill showing why they're the class of the OUA East with an early 2-0 lead against Nipissing.
Well, you got to right there, Rose and McNichol, combining again for another goal. As you saw the first goal of the game, it was McNichol setting up Rose. Rose returns the favor and sets up McNichol right there to give the Redmen a 2-0 lead.
The number one line already producing 5 points in 10 minutes of play in the first period. Right now, McGill up 2-0 here on SSN Canada. Brent Brock and Mo Khan here at McConnell Arena. Homecoming weekend. A lot of sports going on right now. Basketball going on at the Love Competition Hall. And then tomorrow afternoon is McGill football. They take on Sherbrooke and women's soccer, men's rugby, you name it. McGill is busy this weekend with a lot of sports with their varsity team. Matthew Pompey wins the draw. Still a battle right now. Levesque in there as well. Ben Levesque can't get to it. Mitchell does for Nipissing. Around the net goes. LeMay keeps it in play. Mitchell now fighting for it. McGill really winning the board battles against Nipissing. Back over to Levesque, the captain of the team. Hit from behind. Starting pass behind the net. McGill really keeping the puck deep into Nipissing territory. They can't retain possession yet. Big hit coming up there. And away comes Nipissing, clearing the puck finally. Deacon, number 66, over the blue line. Shoots. Blocked. Capped in by Nipissing. Deep into McGill territory. Deacon fighting for the puck. And cleared away calmly by Levesque. Rink-wide pass to Matt, to Bono. Bono can't get to it. Matthew Pompey, number 19, having a great start to the season. Sending pass to no one out there. And Nipissing will retain possession once again. Kept in play by Max Lucio and Colin Campbell. And right now, McGill doing a great job taking away the passing lanes from Nipissing so far in the first period.
But that's exactly it, taking away the passing lanes, and they're creating some turnovers. Once again, we're mentioning the turnovers, and that's been the key right now for the first period for the Lakers, committing a couple of turnovers in their zone and also in their neutral zone, which is leading to a lot of McGill scoring chances.
And the number one line comes back out again. Rose, Delilud, and Cedric McNichol. Out there for Nipissing is Craig Campbell, along with number 77, Chad Thibodeau, who's out there, who's on the far left wing. One by McGill. Shoot, scores. A screenshot goes in off a Poulin shot. Refused, saw it. No way. Had no idea it went in, and it goes in to make it 3-0.
Well, you saw right there, as you mentioned, it's a screenshot. The aforementioned Cedric McNichol, there he is once again in front of the net, blocking the goaltender, Kirk Refuse. And we saw the shot there from the point, and Refuse had no chance on that one.
Dominic Poulin with his first goal of the year on a gorgeous screenshot, going top shelf block side on Kirk Refuse. And you wonder if Nipissing might make a goalie change at some point. As already they're down 3-0 just inside 10 minutes of the first period here. Timeout called by Nipissing. A good time out for the take to slow down things.
Well, there you go. That's exactly it. You know, head coach Michael McParland, pardon me, taking the time out, settle his team down a little bit. They're down 3-0 right now, early in the first period. I think he needs to settle his team down, get the butterflies out, shake it off, and come back and finish strong in the end of this first period.
And what is Miguel telling their bench right now in terms of the fact they're up 3-0 already less than 10 or inside 10 minutes of the first period.
Well, Coach Kelly knows. I mean, he's got to love the forecheck by his team. His team is hitting hard, hitting the Lakers' defense hard, pardon me. And they're creating a lot of turnovers, getting in the passing lane, as you mentioned before, Mo. So creating a lot of turnovers by the Lakers. So I imagine he's telling his team just to keep it up, keep hitting them, and we'll see what happens.
Laporte. McNichol gets the assist, Poulin with the goal. His first goal of the year. Renard out, the number four for McGill. Fighting for it behind the net to the right of Gervais Renard. Brunel. He'll bring it over his blue line, over center ice now. Away he comes. Max Lucier coming down the right wing line. Turning pass. No one there and kept in play. Now, great job by Laporte. And here comes Nipissing. 3-on-2. Campbell. Pass. Horvath shoots just wide of the net. And Brunel will keep it briefly here, and he'll keep it back to his defense to Sam Lebrecht, the former NCAA player, playing for the McGill Redmen.
You got to give credit right there to the goalie there, Gervais Renard. That's the first shot he's seen in a couple of minutes, and he was obviously sharp on that save right there.
Patton, number 9, one of the top goal scorers for Nipissing. Dumps it in. Retained by McGill. Around the boards it goes. Here's Neil Prokop. Rink-wise, 70 pass, almost a giveaway. Lucky for McGill, retained. Braun coming down the right wing. Backhand saved by Refuse, and Hill will stop play with 8:12 left here in the first period. The game brought to you by Classifieds, Varsity 515. Stop wasting your time on Classifieds. Excellence in student living. Varsity 515. MoCon Brent Bakken here on SSN Canada. 3-0 lead for the McGill Redmen over the Nipissing Lakers. The first of two games in a row for the Redmen as they take on the Laurentian Voyageurs tomorrow night here at McConnell. As they split last weekend in Ontario, as they went 1-1, losing to OIT, beating Queen's University. McGill's home record was a fortress. Tip shot just wide of the net. They went 12-2 last year. Meanwhile, Nipissing was 3-11 on the road. So not the Road Warriors like Hawk and Animal were back in the old WWF days. To use a reference like that.
That's a great reference right there, Mo. That's a great reference. Hopefully for some of the viewers out there, they don't figure out our age.
I don't worry about that. Here comes Nipissing. Giveaway again by Nipissing. Their fourth turnover of the day. And they have not done a good job clearing the puck out of their zone. Poulin slips. Can they capitalize? Bailey, partial 2-on-1. And he is hit by Neil Prokop from behind. No whistle on the play. And Levesque will clear it away calmly up to Matthew Pompey. Coming off his off wing without being icing. No icing call. Pompey does win it briefly. Battle for the puck. Five players in the back. Three blue shirts, two white shirts. Finally cleared away. Loose puck. Levesque loses his stick. Laporte to Matthew Pompey, and he'll clear it away as Nipissing will make some changes with the four line, as will McGill. Ben Levesque off and Rose coming on. And the aforementioned Rose can't handle the puck. Hit by Smith in front of the Nipissing bench. And McGill will calmly play in center ice over the blue line now. Shot. Saved by Refuse. Behind the net it goes. And cleared away. That will be icing. Most likely, no, it will not be icing. Shrinar will play behind the nets. 6:40 left here in the first period. Cedric McNichol and the number one line doing their damage early on, combining for 6 points. Bernard over the left wing. Center pass, no one there. Behind the net it goes, and just off into center ice, into no man's land. Sam Lebrecht. Bernard can't handle it. Here comes Cedric McNichol coming down the right wing. McNichol coming over the backhand now. Well played by Nipissing. Rose, McNichol, DeLille Oud in for the number one line. Puck behind the net. McNichol still with possession. Lebrecht back over. No shot. Down low is Rose. Rose calmly over to Lebrecht. Lebrecht shoots. Oh, just off. And missing the target by Lebrecht. Fight for the puck in the corner of the rink right now. Sending pass, Lebrecht shoots just wide of the net again. Kept in by McGill. Good puck rotation by Redmond. Sending pass, DeLille Oud shoots. Received by Refuse. And McGill hovering, buzzing around, keeping the puck with great puck rotation. Lebrecht can't keep it in, and Nipissing will make a change along with McGill. McGill, great pressure on that play, Brent.
Well, you can see the Lakers right now, a lot of the defenders coming off the ice. They look like they're super tired on that one. They're lucky to get the puck out.
And they have no timeout now. They used it in the first period, so they have to be very conservative and smart with their line changes.
And I think that's a perfect opportunity right now for the Redmen to keep on with the pressure. Obviously, as I just mentioned, the Lakers are tired, so McGill needs to keep on with the up-tempo, fast pace, and see what they have in the old in the gas tank, the Nipissing Lakers.
Hugo Laporte up ice to Brunell over the blue line, going through three blue shirts. Shoots, saved by Refuse, kept in by McGill. Pass out now. Boutte shoots. Another save by Refuse. They're just blistering in with shots galore right now in the first 60 minutes of this game. Here's Jimmy McDowell, the former OHL star. Up ahead now is Nipissing. McDowell. Campbell now. Colin Campbell is number 89. 70 pass blocked by Brunell. Boutte, big hit on Campbell. No whistle on the play.
Boutte, the big rugged defenseman. Hard-nosed defenseman right there for the Redmen. Putting 89 there. Campbell right on his backside.
Traffic in front of Gervais Chouinard. Serving pass now. Tipped away by McGill. And it will be cleared away. Braun up ahead. Prokop, number 21. Serving pass. Offer refused again. And he is being blistered with shots galore in this first period.
Yeah, you definitely have to give credit right there to the goaltender, Kirk Refuse. I mean, right now it is 3-0, but it could easily be 6-7-0 considering the amount of shots that the Redmen are getting on net.
Ben Levesque, the captain of the team, number 27. Kept in by Nipissing, but it is offside. Delay call coming up here, but Sam LeBrec will get the puck back here with 3:45 left in the first period. McGill up 3-0 on SSN Canada. Almost a giveaway at center ice. It is a giveaway. Campbell can't get to it. Now he does. Thibodeau trying to get to Horvat, and he won't get to it. Pompey trying to kick it up. Kept in by Nipissing. Now over the blue line, back to center ice it goes.
You got it like number six right there, Sam LeBrec, with a good defensive play to he was able to come back down and help out with the turnover and got the puck out of the zone for the Redmen.
Big hit along the boards. Bailey got hit. LeMay keeps it behind the net. Laporte kept in by Nipissing. Sending pass into the corner. Laporte will clear it. Just Bailey up to Rose, and he'll get up ahead. Big hit by Nipissing. Goes back in the corner. 2:58 left here in the first period. 3-0 for the McGill Redmen.
You see a couple smiles right now on the Redmen bench after that big hit on the boards by number 15, Jonathan Bonneau.
Dion loses the puck. Almost a giveaway it is. Deloud, the wrong guy you want to give the puck to. And he'll refocus with Cedric McNichol. McNichol almost on a power play now, even though it's 5-on-5. And here's Patton, one of the top goal scorers for Nipissing. Over the blue line, he comes down the left wing. Patton shoots just over the net. And it'll come back to Deloud over center ice. He's hooked, and a penalty call coming up here as Robichaud will go to the box for 2 minutes with 2:23 left here in the first period.
Yeah, I think number 74 there, Eric Robichaud, looks like he doesn't really agree with that call. I think he thinks that the McGill player might have just fell, incidental contact. And actually, you know what? The penalty looks like to be on McGill right now.
And it's going to be on McGill, number 28, Patrick Deloud. My guess they're going to be calling him for...
Yeah, they might be calling him for diving.
Diving, potentially speaking here. We'll see what the call is. Embellishment most likely than not here. So McGill will be a man down, it appears. We'll get the exact call, but it is 5-on-5, so this might be incidental penalties. It is, so it'll be 5-on-5 right now. So both teams have minors called against them. 3-0 lead here. 2:22 left in the first period on SSN Canada. Mocon, Brent Bakken here. We apologize for the early inconvenience as we had a bit of a technical difficulty. And now we're fine. We're coasting our way through in this game.
Better late than never.
Exactly. Boutte over the blue line. Shot off on Refuse. And that, again, he's being peppered galore. Nipissing can't get puck possession. McGill does. Pass over. Lassier, the intended player, couldn't get to it. Kept in by Tardif LeMay. Brunell, behind the net. Brunell trying to find someone, can't find anyone, and he will rotate it down low. Back over to Vincent Bernard, who's behind the net, number 4. Pitching down low. Pass over it, loose puck, and it will be cleared away by Nipissing as Boutte will go back to retrieve the puck for McGill. Double hit by Nipissing. Up ahead now is Richard, Tardif Richard. Simon Tardif Richard coming down the right wing. Shoots! Another save by Kirk Refuse. And right now, he's trying to refuse as many pucks as he can in this first period.
You got to like that one. I like that one, Mo. You see right there on that save, Refuse looks like he got a little bit lucky. Looks like there's a bit of luck on that side and on that save. It's a good shot right there. And looks like he got a piece of it, but he wasn't really sure where the puck was. So we'll see if the Redmen want to shoot from that angle a little bit more and get some more pucks on net.
1:36 left here in the first period. 3-0 lead for the McGill Redmen, as McGill will bring out their fourth line, Jerome Raymond, Trevor Braun, and Neil Prokop. Draw one by Nipissing. Behind the net it goes. Braun fighting for the puck along the boards, along with Raymond, number 26. Three blue shirts to two white shirts for McGill. Still along the boards, now cleared away by Nipissing. Hit off Neil Prokop's right skate. Prokop with the puck. Hit by Gleason. McDowell, number 95, trying to win the puck possession. He does, and Nipissing will get it back to McNeil, number 42. Around the boards it goes. It will be cleared away. Up ahead it will. Here comes Jimmy McDowell, the former OHL player with the Erie Otters. Up into the corner is Sam Lebrec. Last minute play left in the first period. Shot, tip, loose puck. No one there for Nipissing, and McGill will get it up ice. 2-on-2 coming up. Raymond, Prokop, tip shot, almost on target. Just missing the left post. McDowell can't keep it in. Prokop fighting for it with three blue shirts right now. Four blue shirts. And McDowell, Prokop, penalty coming up here. On McGill, it appears.
It looks like it's going to be a cross check, I think, on the captain, Benoit Levesque.
And Benoit Levesque will go off for 2 minutes with 33.2 seconds left here. McGill taking some undisciplined penalties late in the period.
Yeah, definitely. That's something that I'm sure Coach Gnomes is going to have to talk to his, sorry, he's going to talk to his team about at the end of this first period. Because, yeah, it is a 3-0 lead, but as you've seen in any hockey game, that could easily disappear.
So far this year, McGill has been pretty decent, as the opponent power play penalty kill has been pretty good for themselves. McGill's power play, in fact, has been 7-for-40. Interesting, meanwhile, not the best right now. In fact, they have been outscored 27-11 in their first five road games of last year. So goals have been a premium for them last year. But this year, it's been a revelation how well they've been off to a strong start with a 2-1-1 record, with their offense clicking right away. 17 seconds left here. Schrinard, behind the net it goes. Kept in. Can he get off one more shot? Nipissing, McDowell, loses the handle. Lucier trying to clear it away, kept in, and he will get it out there. And that will probably do it for the first period with 3 seconds left here.
You got to love that effort right there by number 9, Max Lucier, to get in the puck out of his own zone. He was flat on his stomach, and he was still able to do it.
Well, at the end of one, it is 3-0 for the McGill Redmen, the hometown team, up on homecoming weekend here at McConnell Arena. This is the first two games for the Redmen, as they'll take on the Laurentian Voyagers tomorrow night at 7 p.m. at McConnell. Grand Baca Mocon here. We'll take a brief break, reset, get you geared up, recap the first period, and get you geared up for the second period here in the Ye Olde Orchard. First intermission, Ye Olde Orchard, the place to be, with 18 beers on tap, a variety of scotches, wings, and butter chicken. The Orchard is the place to be, Ye Olde Orchard, here on SSN Canada. So at the end of one, 3-0 McGill over Nipissing on your home of McGill Athletics, SSN Canada. Test. Test, test. Welcome back to the Ye Olde Orchard First Intermission Reports. And stats were key here, and we'll reset in terms of the pregame thoughts we had here, and we'll talk about, again, McGill's veteran departures. In the first period, did not look like they lost to be with some guys moving on to their post-hockey careers here, Brent. Early on, they took the lead and were 3-0 at the end of one.
But that's very much. You mentioned, you know, some of the guys that left, especially Ryan McKiernan, key player last year, arguably one of the best players on the team, Neil Blunden. But there's guys that are stepping up in their place. Obviously, there's a captain, number 27, Benoit Levesque. The aforementioned, who we mentioned, I should say, a lot in the first period, number 28, Patrick Delahoud, and number 11 as well, Cedric Menickel. But there's also number 4, Vincent Barnard, who's stabilizing the back end of that D. So, yeah, you know what? The Redmen did lose some leadership last year, but a lot of guys are stepping up and taking the leadership role.
The McGill strength so far in how they've played up till now, I mean, they have done a great job, and we're seeing it right now as evident by their puck possession, and they're winning the board battles so far.
They're winning the board battles, they're getting that puck possession, and one of the ways they're doing that is by using their team speed. Talking to Coach Kelly Nobbs there yesterday, he mentioned to me that one of the things they wanted to improve during the offseason was the team depth and the team speed. They feel like in their loss in the playoffs to the Alberta Golden Bears, they felt that the Golden Bears were a bit of a deeper team, maybe even a bit of a faster team. So Coach Jones wanted to improve that. And as we see so far, a lot of that speed is paying off for the Redmen, which is they're using it to create a lot of turnovers.
And finally, we talk about the schedule this year. Of course, McGill will play a lot of back-to-back games. In fact, they will face a lot of teams who will have at least a night's rest before they face them on the back end of a two-game doubleheader for McGill. Case in point, tomorrow they'll play Laurentian here at McConnell. How important is it for McGill to really keep themselves rested and also not really put themselves in a position where they might get hurt and some guys might have to play more than not in games like this today?
Well, getting hurt, obviously, I mean, that's something that that happens in any sport you play. But as I just mentioned, depth was one of the key things that Coach Holmes wanted to improve this offseason. And having those games, having those back-to-back games and playing the back end of that back-to-back against a team that, you know, is coming off of a bit of a rest, that depth is going to be key right now for the Redmen going forward this season.
This game brought to you by the Montreal Gazette. Go online, montrealgazette.com, for the latest news in and around the world and, of course, in the Montreal area for your news and stories. The Montreal Gazette, a proud sponsor of McGill Athletics, Molson Export, Molson X, proud sponsor as well. Ye Olde Orchard, 4 locations in Montreal. Once you go after the game, on the one on Prince Arthur, just off of St. Lawrence, Coca-Cola, Saputo, Milk to Go, all proud sponsors. Delta Montreal, ask for their friends and family discount rates. Delta Montreal, proud sponsor of McGill Athletics. So as we gear up for the second period here at McConnell, McGill up 3-0 on SSN Canada, your home of McGill Athletics. A lot going on. Don't forget, tomorrow afternoon we'll have the football call as the home school McGill Redmen will take on the visiting Sherbrooke Valley Owls. A do-or-die game for the Redmen as they hope to keep their playoff hopes alive. Moving forward, we'll have women's soccer and men's soccer on Sunday afternoon. Homecoming weekend, a lot going on here, Brent.
McGill obviously is the place to be this weekend. As you mentioned, homecoming weekend, there's no better spot in the city of Montreal to be than right here at McGill.
Look at the first period stats. McGill outclassed the Nipissing Lakers 17-4 shot advantage. They peppered Kirk Refuse galore with shots nonstop here. The number one line, we talk about Patrick Delahoud, Cedric McNichol, and of course David Rose having a force 5 points combined with those three players.
As I mentioned before, the team speed, using the pace, coming out being fast tempo team. And as you can see right there, especially with that first line, as you mentioned, with Rose, McNichol, and Hood, creating a lot of turnovers and getting 6 points, as you mentioned, right now for the Redmen. So we'll see if they can keep that up in the second period.
We'll see that as well. And Kirk Priest still in nets here. Again, he faced 17 shots in the first period and saved 14 of them. So he was definitely peppered galore. But we'll see what they do for Nipissing. You look at their goal scoring. Craig Campbell, 2 goals this year. Matt Patton, 2 goals, 3 assists. 3 assists held in check. Brogan Bailey, 3 goals, no assists. Colin Campbell, 3 goals and 0 assists. And these guys are going to be relied upon. So if Nipissing wants to get back to this game, the first 5 minutes are going to be very key for them to at least get 1 goal moving forward.
Yeah, they're definitely going to need a goal, and they're definitely going to need to show that they can get the puck out of the zone consistently and make the smart passes because, as I mentioned before, and as you mentioned as well, Mo, with the turnovers that McGill was forcing on the Lakers, that's something that they just can't have in the second period if they want to have any chance of coming back in this game. Because, as you said, it's a 3-0 lead right now for the Redmen. But if it wasn't for the goaltender Kirk Rafuz, it could easily be a 6 or 7-0 lead right now.
McGill will be shorthanded for another minute 27 as Ben Levesque in the penalty box as he took a very late penalty in the first period. We'll see if Nipissing can reply back with a goal here in the second period. Play underway at McConnell. 3-0 lead for the Redmen on SSN Canada. Up ice comes Nipissing. And over the blue line, cleared away by McGill over center ice. Nipissing will get it back to McDowell. Cross rink tipped away by McNichol. Bernard Lassier out there for McGill along with Laporte. And into the corner it goes. Bailey fighting for it against Bernard. Won by Nipissing. Back up top to McDowell. Working it around the rink it goes. McDowell. Robichaud. Back to McDowell. McGill forcing the play up around the perimeter of their box. Patted down low to Robichaud. Robichaud trying to find some 70 pass shoots. No one there for Nipissing. And McGill will get it out over the blue line and cleared away. A 2-1.
Chance right now for the Redmen.
Shoots. Scores. Gorgeous goal coast to coast is number 8, Simon Tardif-Richard. His first points this year going glove side to make it 4-0 for the Redmen.
Yeah, what a shot there by Tardif-Richard over the shoulder of the aforementioned number 33, Kirk Rafuz, right there. You got to imagine if you're the Nipissing Lakers, you like your goalie to make a stop on that one. And just as I mentioned that, looks like they're having a goalie change.
And they will make a goalie change, and they will go to their backup. Cole Holowenko will come in from Penticton, B.C., as Simon Tardif-Richard from Gatineau, Quebec, opened up his account this year for the McGill Redmen, scoring shorthanded. In fact, that's McGill's second shorthanded goal of the season, preseason and regular season included. And they're up comfortably now, 4-0, a minute into the second period.
We'll see if Holowenko.
His first of the season scored on shorthanded by number 8, Simon Tardif-Richard. Unassisted at 57 seconds. Here they Redmen, son premier de la saison.
Holowenko now in nets for Nipissing, Granton. We'll see what he can do to hold this barrage by McGill to a standstill. Up ahead now, De La Oud, 1-on-1, coming down. Oud shoots just over the net, shoots in front of the net, no one there. McNichol got a stick on it, but couldn't get into the net.
Okay, McNichol looks like he's a bit upset with himself. Sorry, wasn't able to bang home that rebound.
3-on-2 now for Nipissing. Campbell coming over, well played by McGill. Shot saved by Srinard, loose puck. Rose will get it back and calm and go behind the net as Nipissing will make a line change. Rose coming down his off wing now. Over the blue line. Rose cutting through. Thibodeau harassing him. Played behind the net. McGill will make a change quickly. Lebrecht keeps it in. Sam Lebrecht, the only player along now with Pompey. McGill really buzzing around, forcing Nipissing into their zone, not giving them any space to work with.
You got to like what the Redmen are doing right here with that aggressive forecheck, continuing what they were doing in the first period, and has Nipissing once again on their toes on defense.
Pompey shot saved by Holowenko, and it will be a quick whistle and faceoff draw in Nipissing zone. So McGill rolling with their four lines, Nipissing trying to get a shot on net here as they were outshot 17-4 in the first period, and right now have been odd shots in the second period at McConnell. Out there for the Redmen is Pompey. Levesque. Won by Pompey. Kept in by Laporte. Laporte jumps in down to Bonneau. Levesque fighting for it along with Bonneau. Bonneau keeps it in. Levesque. Pass over to Laporte. Laporte shoots wide of the net. Bernard keeps it in. Great job of McGill again with the puck rotation.
Looks like McGill's playing takeaway right now with the puck possession that they're having right now in the Lakers' defensive zone.
Loose puck. Nipissing finally clears it away over center ice. But back out. A quick 2-on-1. Could have been, but it was a delayed offside. Pompey will tip it back in to Nipissing's back end. Holowenko playing the puck. Pompey around along with Horvat. Horvat coming down the right wing. Over the blue line it comes to Gamble. Campbell well defended by Levesque. Big hit as Prokop got hit and rocked along the boards. But LeMay will retain possession. Neil Prokop over center ice. Over the blue line now. Dumps it in calmly. Prokop harassing Mitchell. Braun keeps it in. Braun, space to work with. Semi pass, loose puck. No one there for McGill, but three blue shirts, and away comes Smith. Smith, shot, easy save for Chouinard. Doug Harvey, now number 19, keeps it in to Smith. Smith being harassed by Braun. Braun trying to clear it. Dion keeps it in, and Chouinard will calmly get it back behind the net.
I remember right there, getting a little physical to take the puck away from the Lakers.
Up over the blue line it goes. Whistle delayed. No, kept in by McGill. Penalty coming up against Nipissing, and that'll go back the other way. So McGill will go on the power play, depending if they score or not on this sequence.
But the Redmen have the extra attack right now as Gervais Chouinard has left the net.
Poulin. Over his blue line, over center ice now. Poulin, space to work with. Trying to center it. Can't do it. Fans on the pass. Finally touched by Doug Harvey, and Nipissing will be going to the box. We'll see who will be the culprit for the Lakers. It looks like it is Deacon, number 66, going in the box for Nipissing. Mitch Deacon, the 6'4", 200-pounder from Port Moody, B.C., going in the box. And so far, McGill has been very effective on their special teams, and they could cash in again, maybe make this a 5-0 lead for them in the second period.
Well, I think it's pretty safe to say that the Redmen have been pretty effective all game in every facet, so... This 4-0 hole could get a little bigger right now for the Lakers.
Good around the boards very weakly by Nipissing. Kept in by Brunel. Brunel now, number 18. Over to Lebrecht. Down low. Back to Brunel. Good pass by McGill. Here is Lebrecht again, number 6. McNichol. 50 minutes left here in the second period. 70 pass. Rose can't get to it. Fan on the shot and cleared away by Nipissing. McNichol with the puck. Patton going off for Nipissing, and McGill will try to capitalize on the advantage right now. Brunel over the blue line, being harassed by two blue shirts. Still with puck possession as trying to fight over Horvat and Gleason. Brunel down low. McNichol back to Brunel. Brunel looking calmly. Lebrecht can't handle the puck, and he'll chip it away deep into Rose territory. Dilla Oud, the number one line still out there, having a great game. Starting pass, Rose shoots just over the net. Brunel, McNichol can't handle the pass. Dilla Oud, down low, working with the power play. 50 seconds left here. This number one power play unit has been out there for the entire duration. Brunel, down low, Rose, space, shoots, starting pass. Great save by Holowenko, can't get to it, and another save by Holowenko. McNichol gives it away, and away comes Bailey, and McGill will make a change along with Nipissing. Bailey coming down the right wing. Space to work with. Bailey comes up. Backhand shoots. Great save by Chouinard. As there's 25 seconds left here in the power play. Big hit by Bailey. McGill makes a quick change here. Can Nipissing capitalize on this? Doug Harvey, number 19, will calmly throw it on net. Saved by Chouinard. His best save so far to date. Not much action for Gervais Chouinard, Laporte, and McGill will not capitalize on this power play advantage kept in by Doug Harvey. And 13:28 left here in the second period, 4-0 lead for the Redmen, but they couldn't score on that power play.
No, they couldn't score on that power play, so you got to tip your hat right there to the Lakers' penalty kill on that one.
Pompey coming off his off wing. Pompey going around the net now, being harassed by Mitchell. Kept that by Bonneau, Laporte. Space to work with Laporte. Calmly over to Bonneau. Bonneau back to Laporte. Shot. Screenshot. Holowenko did not see it until the last second. Prokop around the boards it goes. Poulin now. Back in front of the nets. And Prokop couldn't tip it in. Center pass around. And McGill really perfect with the pass. Shoots. Saved by Holowenko. McGill really controlling the boards and the passing lanes.
Really controlling the boards right now. They're being really aggressive. And so far the Lakers have no answer for it.
Thibodeau with a long shot. Easy save for Jacob Gervais Chouinard, the Sherbrooke native. So far coming to the game with a 3.00 goals against average, but right now playing a fantastic game. Holding serve and keeping the goose egg alive for his shutout.
Yeah, you got to give a lot of credit right there to Gervais Chouinard. You also got to give some credit to his defense. They're taking the body to the Lakers forwards and making it really hard for Nipissing to get any quality shots on Gervais Chouinard.
12:39 left here on SSN Canada. Second period action. McGill up 4-0. This game brought to you by Ye Olde Orchard, your go-to bar and great food at Ye Olde Orchard. Here comes Raymond. Raymond, well defended by Nipissing, and Nipissing will try to capitalize. Morrison now over center ice. 1-on-3 for Morrison. Has reinforcements now. Shot saved by Gervais Chouinard, and a whistle called again. 12:20 left here. This game brought to you by Ye Olde Orchard. Best pub and grill and best bars in Montreal. Ye Olde Orchard, a past sponsor of McGill Athletics. Brent Bakken-Mocon here. And right now, Nipissing has no answer to muster any quality opportunities on net against Jacob Gervais Chouinard.
But there you go. That's exactly it, Mo. I mean, even the shots they're getting in right now on the McGill goaltender are from really far out. Chouinard's not having really much to do at all. He's making some easy saves. So we'll see if they can maybe beat the Lakers up the tempo a little bit and get more aggressive and maybe drive some pucks and get some quality shots on net.
Faceoff won by McGill. Kept in by Patton. Patton, number 9, one of the top goal scorers for Nipissing. Centering pass, can't get to it. Kept in alive by Nipissing. Behind the net it goes. Cleared away now. Still kept in. Knuckler over the net. Good rotation by Nipissing. This is the best effort so far in this second period. Cleared away by McGill. Big hit along the boards. Fighting for it right now is Brunel. Turned it for Richard. And Nipissing will get it back to Bailey. Bailey trying to get to Robichaud, but he wasn't there and was paying attention. Now Robichaud has speed to work with. Coming down the left wing. Robichaud shoots. Stands on the shot. Lebrecq tries to clear it, but can't do so. Bailey now off the boards. Great job by Bailey to keep it alive. Hit from behind. No penalty call on that play. And McGill will get it out to Brunel. Lesieur stops, waits for more reinforcements. Behind the net he goes. With puck possession still, loose puck, still behind the net is Cedric McNichol. He's out there now with Max Lesieur. Up ice now it goes. Campbell dumps it into the McGill territory. Bernard can't get to it. McNichol will, and he will calmly bring it up ice. Credit to pass to Rose. Rose. Back to McNichol. McNichol space. And a tip shot. Jason tips it away. Bernard now. Bernard behind the net as McGill hovering again. Halilenko's been good so far on his saves. Rose. Rink pass. Shot just wide of the net again. Bernard can't keep it in, and Rose will bring it back out to Laporte. 10:30 left here in the second period, as McGill up 4-0. Ended this game against the Nipissing Lakers of North Bay, Ontario.
Yeah, Laporte right there, number 3. Hugo Laporte had a good shot there. And now you just wish for him, he would have got a little bit more on it.
Here comes Thibodeau. Shot saved by Gervais Chouinard. His biggest test of the game so far. Back up to the point. Shot again. Blocked in front of the net. A lot of traffic. Campbell has it, number 92. Back to the point. Can't keep it in as McNeil, and goes back to center ice as we approach the 10-minute mark here in the second period.
And that's been the Lakers' luck so far this game. They just had a quality offensive chance. I believe it was number 4, then Mitchell had a chance to shoot from the point, and the puck just hopped over his stick.
Mitchell will dump it back into the territory. Nipissing will make a quick change. Not kept in, delayed offside. Harvey can't keep it in, and will be calmly dumped in by Matthew Pompey. Lévesque out there with Bonneau, and McGill will make a quick change with their defensive pairings. Here comes Doug Harvey, number 19, in his off wing. Harvey cutting through, shoots, blocked. Loose puck, LeMay can't get to it. Centering pass, shoots, another great save by Gervais Chouinard. Beyond the net it goes. As Nipissing nipping away here, can't get the puck on net. And here comes Matthew Pompey over center ice. Pompey over the blue line. Beyond the pack, pass, touch pass. Pompey can't get to it. Mitchell tips it away into the corner of the rink.
Looked like Pompey was expecting that return pass right there.
Broke a stick on the ice for Nipissing. Harvey now. Space worker. Dion. Locked again by Poulin. But we look at the McGill back end. Their defensive pairing. Talk about Ryan McKiernan, who is no longer part of the team. Big loss for them. But so far, their defensive pairings have done a great job in holding the fort for this McGill defense.
Well, definitely, you know, it starts with number 5. Francis Lambert-Lemay with teaming up with number 6 is Sam Lebrecq. You have number 3, Hugo Laporte, with number 4, Vincent Barnard. And number 13, Etienne Boutte, teaming up with the goal scorer from the first period, number 23, Dominic Poulin. They're definitely contributing offensively and obviously on the defensive end as well.
Mitchell with the shot, saved by Gervais Renard. Shot again by Mitchell. Screenshot, loose puck. And Nipissing cannot score on that. Big hit along the boards. Fight for the puck battle is Nipissing. They're keeping in a hit from behind. Penalty coming up against Nipissing. And McGill not taking this too kindly as a big hit from behind the net and behind the boards. Along the boards, pardon me. And Nipissing will be going off. And we'll see if it's a five in a major or if it's only a two-minute minor. But I think it might be a double on this one.
And maybe a double, usually the cross shot from behind, a boarding call possibly. Going against the Redmen, so we'll see what happens right here.
We'll get the call from the PA announcer, but right now, McGill will be going to the power play. And who is the culprit? It appears it is number 39 for Nipissing, Brock Morrison from Ontario. So Morrison going off. We'll get the exact call. And McGill will have a power play as they bring up their number one unit. .840 left here. 2 minute boarding call. So not the five in the major here. We thought it would be, but it'll be 2 minutes. We'll see what McGill does. They're 0-1 in this second period on the power play. Brunel out there along with Lebrecq, McNichol, Deloud, and Rose. Rose opened up the game with the opening goal and a gorgeous pass from McNichol. Brunel shoots. Can't keep it in as McNichol, and it goes back down to McGill. So there's a misconduct. Rose, sending pass. Deloud can't get to it. Behind the net it goes to McNichol. McNichol working the board. Sending pass back to Brunel. Shot. Scores. A gorgeous shot from Sam Lebrecq to make it now 5-0 for the McGill Redmen. His second goal of the year. Halilenko had no chance to not see the shot come through as it went glove side on him as Sam Lebrecq scoring a gorgeous goal on the power play. McGill making it 5-0, 8:04 left here in the second period. McGill has been the class of this game and they're showing why they're the best in the OUA East. Lebrecq with the second goal. Shot on net, saved by Gervais Renard. It'll be 7:41 left here in the second period. But again, that power play looked very smooth out there with the passing and seeing Lebrecq score like he did, top shelf. They're getting a lot of traffic in front of Polowenko right now. And Lebrecq showing why he could be the heir apparent to that McKiernan spot. McDowell keeps it in. Shot on net, blocked, loose puck. Gervais Renard will cover it up quickly. 7:25 left here in the second period on SSN Canada. Brent Bach and Mo Khan here. Don't forget, we'll have live football action tomorrow afternoon, 1 p.m. kickoff, as the visiting Sherbrooke Bayhawks take on the McGill Redmen. Win or go home, do or die for the Redmen. If they lose this game, that will essentially end their playoff hopes and aspirations. If they win that game, it keeps them alive in the RCQ race. Meanwhile, here at McConnell, 5-0 lead for the Redmen hockey variety, that is. Starting pass, no connection right there for McGill. Puck along the boards. Harvey can't corral, and away comes Bonneau, coming down the left wing. Bonneau shoots just wide of the net again over the crossbar. Laporte can't keep it in, delayed offside. Where is the puck? No one knows. It's out of play, so whistle on the play. Faceoff won by McGill. Just over the blue line now. Braun. Braun shoots. Saved by Holowenko. LeMay keeps it in. Behind the net is Raymond. Raymond. Good puck rotation to Braun, number 12. Braun being hounded right now. Keeping the puck. Loose puck. Can't keep it into the territory. And it's back into McGill territory. No penalty coming up there. As Dion may have hooked on that play. Horvat. For Nipissing. LeMay. Up to Neil Prokop. Tip pass up at the Raymond. Raymond over the blue line now. Raymond shoots. Easy save for Holowenko and stop and play with 6:19 left here in the second period. Great crowd here at McConnell. Great crowds all over the campus. We have basketball going on right now as we speak. The Redbird Classic. And this game right now, as the fans are very satisfied. Don't forget they'll play tomorrow night here at McConnell. Take on the Laurentian Voyageurs, the back-to-back games for the McGill Redmen, which, as we mentioned before, is going to be a key test for them because some teams will have a day's rest before they face McGill on the back end of a two-game bill. No shot yet. Shot on net, just wide again. Boutte will keep it in. Down to McNichol. Number one line out there for the Redmen. Back to the point. Shot again. Saved by Holowenko. He doesn't know where it is. Loose puck. Whistle blowing as it will be another stoppage in play. Dominic Poulet having a great game so far, gaining the puck on net and really making things confusing for Holowenko and before that with their starting goaltender, Kirk Refuse. Nipissing wins the draw. Puck along the boards, kept in by Poulin. No offside on that play, and Nipissing will get it back. Can he capitalize on the turnover right now? Here comes McDowell coming in the left wing. McDowell, centering pass. Gervais Renard will cover it up. And a little crowd and an injured Nipissing player. We'll see if he's getting up, and he is indeed. But right now, Nipissing has not been able to muster much of a threat around Jacob Gervais Renard, who's had a relatively clean sheet in terms of action in this second period. Draw one by McGill. Up ahead they come over their territory. Over center ice now is Brunel. It's in Nipissing territory. Brunel shoots. Saved by Holowenko. Goes out of play. Whistle on the stoppage. 5:33 left here in the second period. This game brought to you by the Gazette, MontrealGazette.com. Go online, MontrealGazette.com, for the latest news in and around the world. MontrealGazette.com. Brett Bach and Mo Khan here. 5-0 lead for the McGill Redmen as they got off to a quick start on a David Rose goal, and they have not looked back since then. Scores. Bernard scores to make it 6-0 on a screenshot. Holowenko did not see that shot, and it goes in to make it 6-0. It seemed like Vincent Bernard was quite surprised himself that it went in. He had a delayed reaction on that goal, as it is now 6-0 for the McGill Redmen with 5:23 left here in the second period.
Redmen goal. Scored by number 4, Vincent Bernard. Avec l'aide de numéro 18, Jonathan Brunel, et de numéro 3, Hugo
Laporte. 14-7. So Bernard gets the goal. Bernard doing a great job. That defensive end has done a great job. His first goal of the year for Vincent Bernard to make it a 6-0 lead for the McGill Redmen over the Nipissing Lakers. 5:10 left here in the second period, and they are cruising their way. And we look at last year. I mean, they beat Nipissing twice last year, and there were some close affairs in which they won 4-2, and then they won 7-6 in overtime at McConnell, in which Cedric McNichol had a goal and two assists in the victory. Rink-wide pass now. Braun, big hit by Dion. hip check. Laporte shoots. Saved by Holowenko. Raymond keeps it alive. Into the corner it goes. Holowenko. Done a great job in that shot sequence here, but McGill having the pressure. Neil Prokop now, number 21. Fans on the pass. Prokop can't keep it in. Barely kept in, and here comes Thibodeau, number 77, for Nipissing. Over the blue line it goes. Offside it is, as Campbell was a foot ahead of the play. Six nothing lead for the McGill Redmen. Doing a great job on homecoming weekend, which will be a busy 3 days here on the McGill campus. McNeil dumps in deep. Gervais Chouinard will play behind his net. Almost loses the handle. McGill calmly will get it back. Rink-wide pass now to Ben Levesque, the captain of the team. Levesque gets hit by Robichaud, my apologies. Pompey now to LeMay. LeMay shoots just wide of the net. Whistle on the play. We'll see what the call is. And it's going against Ben Levesque, his second penalty of the evening. And Ben Levesque not very happy. So Nipissing will go on the power play with 4:03 left here. 2 minute minor coming up to Ben Levesque. High second call to Benoit Levesque. Nipissing with the puck possession now. Rink wide pass. Shoots. Saved by Gervais Chouinard. And they score. Smith scores for Nipissing to make it 6-1 now. Jared Smith, number 14, scoring for Nipissing. And they capitalize on that penalty on Ben Levesque. Jared Smith scoring his first goal from Red Deer, Alberta, as it is now 6-1, breaking the shutout streak for Jacob Gervais Chouinard. 3:47 left here in the second period, and Nipissing on the board as they're now down 6-1 here at McConnell. Whistle on the play. DeLille Oud getting a little feisty with Doug Harvey, number 19 of Nipissing. And there will be penalties called. And we'll see who is going off, if it's both or only one. And Doug Harvey will be going off, number 19 for Nipissing. A little jibber jabber going from both ends. .340 left here. 2 minute power play coming up for McGill. They capitalized before on a Labrecque gorgeous shot to make it 5-0 at the time. Now 6-1 lead for the Redmen with 3:40 left here. The number one line out there again for the Redmen. Brunel with the puck. Brunel to McNichol. Space working. Brunel one time shoots. Wide of the net. Bailey, can he clear it out? No, he won't. Labrecque keeps it in. Bailey handled by two white shirts for McGill. Kept in by Rose. Brunel. Brunel working around. Centering pass, knuckler. Fans on the shot is Rose, and it goes back into the corner. McNichol to David Rose. Labrecque, will he take a shot? No, great pass. Brunel cannot get the shot off. Rose now, around to McNichol. McNichol, back to the point, it goes to Labrecque. Shoots, saved by Holowenko. McGill keeping the puck possession. They're applying deep, deep pressure now on the Nipissing penalty kill. Pass down low, great job by Nipissing, and a whistle will come up, and a stoppage in play. Two 2:51 left here on SSN Canada's second period, brought to you by Yield Orchard, Delta Montreal. Go on to Delta Montreal's website for the friends and family rate. Delta Montreal, proud sponsor of McGill Athletics. Here at McConnell, 6-1 lead for the McGill Redmen. Homecoming weekend. Draw one by McGill, kept alive by Poulin. Down low, Neil Prokop. Back to Bonneau. Down to Prokop, around, shoots and can't get the puck on net. And cleared away by Nipissing, and they will make a change. No, they'll keep with their guys for now with 2:28 left here in the second period. Up ahead now. Boutte had a play, goes in a stoppage and play. So McGill up 6-1. They have been cruising their way through this game, and they'll play the Laurentian Voyageurs tomorrow night at McConnell. Come on by to the arena. Homecoming weekend. A lot of sports happening all throughout the weekend. Basketball, football, rugby, men's and women's soccer, and men's and women's hockey. So we have a lot here at the arena going on. Bonneau, number 15, plays it off the Karen to Raymond. Back to Bonneau. Bonneau being harassed. Back to the point, goes to Boutte. Boutte keeps it in. Boutte pass down to Raymond, over to Bonneau, who can't get to the end of the pass. Pompey now, number 19. Pompey with the puck. Rotating the puck down low to Raymond. He is hooked by Mitchell. No call on that play. 7 seconds left in the power play. Sending pass, shoots! Halilenko does not make the save. A good block by Nipissing. And Deacon's stick, number 66, is broken, and he's not happy about that. Boutte. Up ahead now, Raymond. Pompey's got space to work with. Pompey shoots, pass, tipped, and no conversion on that for Poulin, who was not able to get the last part of the shaft of the stick onto the puck, onto the net. And here comes Nipissing. Patton. Easy save for Gervais Chouinard. Lassier now. Pass over. No shot yet. Knee on knee. Luckily, no injury on that. Bernard now. Shoots. Off the crossbar. Bailey inside 40 seconds left here in the second period. Vincent Bernard connecting off the crossbar. Sending pass. Gervais Chouinard with a quick save. Bernard, number 4, with the puck, and he'll go behind the net with 30 seconds left here in the second period. LeBrec keeps it in. 19 seconds left. Pass to Lassier. Lassier sends it to Tarlay Fichard. Turning pass, and it goes out of play and go back into McGill territory with 10 seconds left here. Prokop. Nipissing will not get a shot off with 2 seconds left. So at the end of two, a commanding 6-1 lead here for the McGill Redmen over the visiting Nipissing Lakers, who have not had a smooth ride. 8-hour bus ride from North Bay to Montreal. Right now, they are not enjoying this scoreline at the end of two. Stay tuned on SSN Canada. Brent Bach and Mocon. We'll be back with the second intermission stats and get you geared up for the third period here on SSN Canada, your home of McGill Athletics.
Thank you.
Welcome back here to SSN Canada, your home of McGill Athletics. The second intermission brought to you by Domino's Pizza. Go online, domino's.ca, order yourself a nice pizza for this third period. Domino's Pizza, go online, domino's.ca. Brent Bach and Mo Conn here on SSN Canada, your home of McGill Athletics. Homecoming weekend, McGill up 6-1 over the Nipissing Lakers of North Bay, Ontario. And McGill will face the Laurentian Voyageurs tomorrow night here at McConnell. A lot going on, which will get you up to date throughout this broadcast at McConnell Arena. Great crowd. A lot of young students here, so good to see the young and old united as one for the McGill Redmen taking on the Nipissing Lakers. Bring back Brent Brocken. Brent, second intermission. Shots were a lot better, but of course the scoreline is 6-1 McGill. Nipissing right now, we talked about the first 5 minutes being important for them in the second period. That didn't happen for them. How important is this next five for them now? Well, for McGill, again, they will play the Laurentian Voyageurs tomorrow night here, and then they will be heading out to Nipissing next Friday night. So they'll make their trip to Nipissing and Laurentian. So they will have a two-game road trip next week, two long road trips, because Nipissing and Laurentian not that close, very far from here. So as we gear up for the third period, this game brought to you by Yield Orchard, the Montreal Gazette, Redbird Sports Shop, Molson X, Coca-Cola, Milk to Go, Saputo, Delta Montreal of Varsity 515, all proud sponsors of McGill Athletics here on this gorgeous Friday night, a crisp fall day. 6-1 lead for the McGill Redmen as we gear up for this third period action. As we look at this period again for McGill, I'm curious to see if Coach will play the third and fourth lines more to keep his top two lines rested for tomorrow night's game. Pompey Levesque out there along with number 15, Jonathan Bonneau from Sherbrooke, Quebec. Labrec and number 5, Francois Lambert-Lemay out there for the McGill defense. Into Laker territory goes Mitchell. Behind the net he goes. Up ice. Well played by Lemay. Labrec will get back to it and he will clear it away. Up ahead to Bonneau. Back into McGill territory. No one has made a change yet, 30 seconds into this third period. Sam LeBrec scoring a goal in the second period on a gorgeous laser shot, top shelf. Matthew Pompey, number 19. Shoots, sharp angle, and is saved by number 1, Cole Holowenko, who came in for Kirk Refuse. Pompey now, away he comes, space to work with. He trips up on the ice monster biting him on the skates. Robichaud dumps it in off the referee. Whistle called as Nipissing will make a quick line change. Out there now for McGill. Le Sieur, Laporte, Brunel, and number 8, Simon Tardif-Richard, who scored a shorthanded goal along with Vincent Bonnard, who scored and almost had another goal. So everyone has contributed in some shape or form for the McGill attack tonight. Horvat wins a draw for Nipissing. Campbell, Craig Campbell is number 92, dumps it back in. Gervais Chouinard plays out to Bernard. Off the boards to Brunel. Brunel will bring it over his territory. Center ice. Harvett almost lined him up for a hit, and he avoids that. Brunell will calmly dump it into the blue line. Campbell clears it away to Tyler Fichard. Whistle call and a little chirpiness going on. Some chirping and chippiness for both schools. Quillen dumps it in. Funny bounce off to Holomenko, and he calmly clears it away. McNeil off the glass. It goes to Boutte. Boutte can't get to it. Back into McGill territory. Icing called on the play, and we'll bring the puck back to Laker territory. 18-16 left here. Brent Bach and Mo Khan. And don't forget, tomorrow afternoon, 1 p.m. kickoff, SSN Canada will bring you McGill football as they take on the Sherbrooke Bay Aug. A do-or-die game for the Redmen. Win, and they keep their playoff hopes alive. Lose, and that will extinguish any chance for them to have a chance at the playoffs this year. Shot on net, loose puck, wide of the net as Nipissing will get it out to number 66, Mitch Deacon. Can't get it cleared. Braun, shot, saved by Holomenko. Loose puck, Prokop can't get to it. Poulin with a howitzer, and Holomenko made a save on that. Poulin, up ahead. Rink-wide pass now to Braun. Braun space to work with, and a whistle called. Neil Prokop was offside, and a stoppage in play. 17:47 left here in the third. Robichaud wins the draw for Nipissing, and Holomenko will cover the puck as the little Oud was hovering around his net. McGill up 6-1 here in the third period. They split last week, in which they went to Eastern Ontario, and they won at Queens last Friday and lost to OIT 3-2, the ever-hot OIT. And now they're on the way to a potential victory over Nipissing this evening. Down low, the little Oud, backhand, hook, and a penalty coming up, a delayed call. Shot on net, blocked. Around the net it goes. Lebrecht keeps it in. Extra attacker out there for McGill. Centering pass, whistle falling blow, and it looks like Dion will be going off for a hooking call. And Dion indeed going off. We'll get the call from the PA announcer, Graham Naismith, who you can hear on the men's soccer for McGill on Sunday afternoon at 4 p.m. on SSN Canada. 17:22 left here in the third. Pompey out there against Horvat. Horvat wins a draw. Around the boards it goes, and cleared away by Nipissing. So 2 minutes slashing for Dion. And in it goes. McGill on the power play with a minute 38 left here. Bordeaux can't get to it. Around the net it comes. Horvat with the puck, and he will chop it into the crowd, and out of play it goes. 16:50 left here, and McGill going with their second and third line power play options to give the number one line a well-deserved rest. Lebrecht with a shot, Brunell party with a shot going wide. Nipissing trying to clear the puck. Three white shirts, two blue shirts, a minute 12 left in the power play. One by McGill. Brunell shoots, scores. Sam Lebrecht on a gorgeous one-timer pass from Brunell to make it 7-1. Sam Lebrecht with the second goal of the game from Granby, Quebec. And McGill now cruising to 2 points and a victory over the Nipissing Lakers with 16:28 left here in the third period. And you can see the body expression for both benches. Happiness for the team in white and sadness for the team in blue. Brunel gets the true goal on that with a gorgeous pass to Lebrec, who one-timed it in to the five-hole of Holowenko to make it 7-1 here. Play now back in McGill territory. Robichaud taking the draw. Tardif Richard called out. Lesieur taking the draw. Won by Robichaud, kept in by Shannon. Bailey now. Bailey shoots. Easy save for Jacob Gervais-Chouinard, who's had a strong game this evening, Brent. Draw one again by Robichaud. Shot blocked by Tardif Richard. Up ahead is Max Lesieur. Lesieur coming down. Partial break for him. Centering pass. And Raymond could not connect. Up ahead, Raymond keeps it in, but Nipissing will get it back out to center ice. Over the blue line. Shot on net. Gervais United with another big save. And another easy save for him as he has kept it to a minimum for any attack from Nipissing. So Max Lesieur gets the sixth McGill goal, as they make a correction from the previous goal. So Max Lesieur gets on the score sheet with his goal of the game. Lesieur's second goal of the year. Bono in the territory he goes, being harassed by two blue shirts, trying to find space to work with, and away it comes. Nipissing, but they can't get puck control. Back to Lebrec. And he will have the number six, having a strong game. Two goals, making fans easy forget about Ryan McKiernan, who was a superstar with this McGill Redmen. One of the backbones to the defense. Tipped up ahead by Bonneau and his icing. Seamless transition going from Ryan McKiernan to Sam Lebrec. Both are great in their own way here, but Lebrec has that howitzer that we saw on display on his two goals. Dion can't keep it in. Horvat can't keep it in either. Bompe harassing him. And away comes Bono. And a whistle called. And a stoppage in play. 15 minutes left here in the third period. 7-1 lead for the McGill Redmen on SSN Canada. Brett Bach and Mo Khan. And we see how now we're the number one line of course, McNichol, Dalil Uden, Rose having more time on the bench to rest them up here. But they've done their damage in the first period of 5 points alone. So these guys were a tour de force for the Redmen. Prokop, centering pass, back to the point it goes. Boutte with a long shot, wide of the net. Prokop plays it behind, can't get in front of the net. Back out to Poulin. Poulin keeps it in behind the net to Neil Prokop. Prokop being harassed by Mitchell. Prokop gets hit from behind, still with the puck possession. Now is Braun, number 12. Braun trying to find someone, can't get to it. Prokop retains possession. Back out front. No one there but Campbell, and a Nipissing player clears it out to Poulin. Braun, Trevor Braun from Wyndham Center. Up ahead now is Trevor Braun, can't get the puck control. And Craig Campbell bringing it back to his defenseman. Tipped up by Smith, the lone goal scorer for Nipissing. Poulin having a strong game both ends of the rink. Tyler Fitzgerald with the shorthanded goal. It seems like everyone's had a big impact in today's game. Tyler Frischard up ahead now to Brunel. Brunel with a gorgeous pass to Salmon Breck to make it a 7-1 lead. Tyler Frischard now being harassed by Smith and Shannon. Bernard will keep it in. Pinching down low is Vincent Bernard. Over to Tyler Frischard. Centering pass blocked well. Centering pass again in front of the net. Holowenko can't get to it. Lassier shoots just wide of the net on the side of the net, pardon me, as Max Lassier had a chance but couldn't connect on net. Patton, awfully quiet tonight. One of the leading goal scorers for the Lakers has been held to zeros by the McGill defense. Lassier, long shot. Blocker saved by Holowenko. Tipped up ahead into Laker bench. Stoppage of play, 12:52 left here. This game brought to you by Domino's Pizza. Go online, domino's.ca, or order Domino's Pizza. A great way to start your weekend here. Homecoming weekend, that is. A lot going on. Men's hockey, men's and basketball, men's and women's basketball down the hill from us. Football tomorrow, men's and women's soccer, rugby going on. So all the sports happening here at McGill. Homecoming weekend on the McGill campus. The draw won by Nipissing. Kept in by McGill. Cedric McNichol, the number one line out there, along with David Rose and Patrick DeLilleoud. Turnover. Rose, pass. DeLilleoud, great play. McNichol shoots, and a save by Holowenko. Tic-tac-toe, but couldn't finish it off. And Helomenko's had a good third period so far with that big save on Cedric McNichol, who's probably asked himself, how did that not go in? Draw one by McNichol. Tipped up ahead to Rose. McNichol, one-timer shoots wide of the net. Rose behind the net now with DeLilleoud. Lefrec out there along with number five, Francois Lambert-Lemay. Kept in by McNichol. Rink wide pass. Lemay shoots. Steered away by Holowenko. And Nipissing will get the puck possession, and away they come over center ice. Morrison can't get to it. Rose can't keep it, get it out, and Campbell will, and he's hit from McNichol. Battle along the boards right now. Nipissing still with possession. McDowell around the boards it goes, and LeMay will get to it, barely though, and he's hit. DeLilleoud tries to flick it over, and it is cleared away over center ice back to Nipissing. McGill with a quick change. Dion shot just wide of the net. Big hit. McGill, Pompey, 2-on-2 now. Matthew Pompey on his off wing. Behind, can't get around the Nipissing defender, but he gets the puck possession back. Good hustle by Pompey. Campbell can't get to it. Dion can't get to it. Kept in by Boutte. And away comes Nipissing. A 3-on-1. Can they capitalize and punish McGill? Horvat. And a good defensive stand by Boutte to get back and recover in time. A slow moving 3-on-1, need I say. Now that net goes, McDowell. Can't keep it in, is Boutte. Yes, he will tip shot as Pompey almost got on net. Around the net goes back to number 15, Bonneau. Bonneau being harassed right now by Shannon. 2-on-2 and a body check from behind, and a penalty will come up now on number 9 for Nipissing, Matt Patton, who's had a frustrating evening as he'll take a cross-checking call from behind. Well, like we mentioned before, their road record was 3-11, and they're looking at another loss here on the road. Kept in by Boutte. Poulin shoots off the crossbar and out of play. My oh my is becoming a shooting gallery now as Dominic Poulin from Anse-Larette, Quebec, hits the crossbar and went out of play, and it's now become the McGill show of offensive display. Bonneau wins the draw. Back to Poulin, number 23. Poulin calmly with the puck to Bonneau. Raymond back up top to Boutte. Bonneau, Poulin with a shot. Good pass, scores. Great finish by number 15 for McGill. Jonathan Bonneau to make it an 8-1 lead in his first goal of the year from Sherbrooke, Quebec, the native. And again, this has been a complete team effort for the McGill Redmen. All four lines, all three defensive pairings have had an impact in this game to make it an 8-1 lead now with 10-21 left here in the third period on a goal by Jonathan Bonneau on a gorgeous slap pass from number 23. Icing on the call here, and they'll come back to Nipissing territory. 10 minutes left here in the third period. 8-1 lead for the Redmen. They're going to be coasting their way to a 2-point gain on the Nipissing Lakers, who they'll play next Friday on the road as McGill make their way into deep Ontario, heading over to North Bay and Sudbury for their weekend battles against the Ontario rivals. Draw one by Nipissing. Around the boards it goes. Cleared away, kept at the blue line. Big hit on Dudley Richard from Morrison, almost his head rocking in the glass. But Holowenko will stop play. Long pass up ahead, well defended by Laporte and Bernard. Here comes Campbell. Campbell is back end. Good defense. Penalty coming up here for McGill as Campbell was tripped up, and it will be a penalty going against the McGill Redmen, and Nipissing will go on the power play for 2 minutes. Raymond from Rayon-Noranda, Quebec will go to the box for 2 minutes with 9:39 left here in the third period on SSN Canada. Brent Bach and Mo Khan here. McGill up 8-1 and looking to keep it that score, if not more, for the team in white. Bailey as Nipissing will set up the power play. McDowell wide open on across the rink. Back up top to Shannon. Down low now, Robichaud. No pass yet. No shot yet from the McGill, from the Nipissing attack. McGill's defense holding serve almost stolen by Ben Levesque. Kept in by McDowell. McDowell gets hit from Tardif Rashad. Fans trying to cheer on the team in the white. And here comes Tardif Rashad, 1-on-1. Can he score a second shorthanded goal? Well defended by Shannon. A minute 25 left in the power play. 9 minutes left here in the third period. Over the blue line is Patton. Patton. Pass to Shannon. One time shoots. Well defended by Boutte. And he takes a shot off the shin guard. And he's A-OK. Two-on-one now for Nipissing. Can they get a shot on net? No, they won't. Gervais Chenier clears it back into the corner to McDowell. Kept in by Dion. Yes, he will. A minute, less than a minute left here in the power play. Dion can't keep it in, bouncing puck in, but he'll have possession. Lassier steals it from him and try to kill some seconds to Boutte, who will now work the clock and clear the puck into Nipissing territory. 8:13 left here in the third period. Mitchell with the puck behind the net. 30 seconds left in the power play for Nipissing, and they've been powerless on their power play. Another save for Gervais Chouinard on Colin Campbell. Behind the net it goes. Dalil Oud fighting for the puck. A slash in the face, no high stick call on Dalil Oud. Nipissing. Mitchell can't get up the shot down low. Campbell looking for an open man. Rink wide pass stolen by McNichol. Mitchell can't keep it in. Away they come. Cedric McNichol and Dalil Oud. 2-on-2. McNichol stops. Free shot. Cross ring pass. Back to McNichol. Can't get it off. as Perron tried to get that pass off and couldn't get it up ahead. Laporte, my apologies, tried to get the pass off but couldn't get it up ahead. Kept in by Nipissing. Pass wide open is Campbell. Will he take the shot? No, it goes to his backhand. Back to the point. Good passing by McNeil. Shot on net, tip. Can't get the shot on net is Morrison. 7:09 left here in the third period. Lebrecq with the puck, who has two goals tonight. Lebrecq to Rose, the aforementioned big hitter. Rose, space to work with. As Neil Prok up to his right, and a quick whistle as Holowinkel will cover it up with 6:48 left here. Stay tuned for the Ye Olde Orchard postgame show. Brent and I will go over the third period stats and get you geared up for the weekend. A lot going on here at McGill homecoming weekend. And, of course, McGill will play Laurentian Voyageurs tomorrow night at McConnell. So, double dip of hockey for our hockey fans who enjoy McGill Redmen hockey. Loose puck retained by Doug Harvey, and he gives it up to McNeil. McNeil slowed up just before the blue line into Jacob Gervais-Renard. A strong game, only allowing one goal on his Smith second period marker. Raymond over center ice. Four blue shirts back. Raymond tries to deke out. Poulin retains possession. Centering pass, no one there for McGill. Harvey now gets it over the blue line, back out to LeMay, who calmly gets up to Poulin. Long pass tipped up by Braun. 6 minutes left here, and again, McGill, quick line changes right now, keeping guys fresh in this last third of the period. Eight-one lead here for the McGill Redmen. They'll get the victory, indeed, unless something happens of dramatic surprise if they somehow score 9 goals, but we'll see about that. Bernard chips it deep into Levesque. Levesque behind the net to Bonneau. Big hit by Bonneau. Sending pass to Levesque. Can he get the puck? Loose puck. No one has it. Scramble. Whistle finally blown as Holowinkel will cover up. And if you look at it right now, Holowinkel's played a really good second half of the game here, and I wonder for Nipissing, when they play McGill again, will they go with their backup, Cole Holowinkel from Penticton, B.C.? Campbell can't play it. Delayed offside. Now he attacks Laporte. Pass over to Vincent Bonneau. Up ahead now is McGill. Space to work with. Dumped in by Brunel. Tadej Fischart trying to hound Dion, and he can't get to him. Dion, long pass giveaway here. Can he capitalize? Great block by Dion. Loose puck. A fan shot by Brunel, and he couldn't get the puck on net here as Horvat came back on defense. Over the blue line, it comes back out to center ice. Bernard dumps it back in, and an easy save for Holowinkel. 5 minutes left here in the third period. Mitchell, beyond the net, working up ice, is the Nipissing Lakers. Patton, who's been held scoreless so far tonight. And away comes McGill. Can they capitalize and punish Nipissing on the line change? No, they won't. Dion recovers in time and gets it up ice, loose puck around the blue line. Dion now. Over the blue line he comes. Dion, sending pass in front of Gervais-Renard. He makes a quick save, net off the moorings, and a stoppage in play with 4:27 left here in the third period. This game brought to you by Varsity 515. Stop wasting your time on classifieds. Excellent instant living. Varsity 515. Check it out, Varsity 515. Out for the draw, Cedric McNichol against Robichaud, number 74, and McNichol wins that. Hit from behind Poulin on Bailey, and McGill will get it out of their territory to Dalil Oud over center ice, and he gets hit by Gleason. They might put you and I in the game to keep everyone fresh. Puck over center ice. Bailey. Big hit by Boutte, and it's become a chippy affair now the last 2 minutes or so with some big hits being thrown from each team. Rose. Up center ice is, and another big hit by DeLille. Ooh, no penalty call on that play. Campbell gets hooked by Rose, but no call. Referees allow them to play, and finally a call will be made as David Rose will go to the box for 2 minutes on a hooking call. David Rose will go into the box for 2 minutes. The long game native opening up the game with an early 1-0 lead inside the first 5 minutes of this game on a gorgeous pass from Cedric McNichol. And McGill has not looked back since then as they have coasted through this game up by 7 with 338 left in the third period. Draw one by Nipissing. Dion. High shot tipped into the mesh. It goes and out of play. Morrison and Tarek Fouchard set to take the draw to the left of Gervais Chouinard. One by Nipissing. Dion again. McGill in a box formation. Down low to McDowell. McDowell cross ring pass. Campbell looking for a pass. Shoots. Saved by Gervais Chouinard. Loose puck. Who has it? No one does. Back to Nipissing. Getting very close to make it 8-2. Campbell again. Circles. Campbell rolling back here. 1:30 left in the power play. Looking for the starting pass again. McDowell can't get to it. Cut away by McGill, and then make a quick line change with 1:20 left in the power play inside 3 minutes in the third period. Morrison over center ice. Morrison, touch pass now to Doug Harvey. Spin move by Doug Harvey. Can't get around Boutte. Stolen by Lassier. Lassier, can he get around? Yes, he will. Lassier, partial break. Lassier comes in, shoots. Saved by Holowenko. Goes off into the glass. As Max Lassier was close to making the 2 shorthanded goals from McGill Redmen tonight. . 51 seconds left in the power play, 2:29 left here in the third period. Don't forget, tomorrow afternoon, Brent Bakken and I will have the call for McGill football as they take on the Sherwick Valley All on SSN Canada, your home of McGill Athletics. And Sunday, there'll be a double dip of soccer. Men's action at 4 o'clock. And women's action at 6 p.m. University of Montreal. Carabin will be visiting the McGill Redmen and McGill Martlets Sunday afternoon on homecoming weekend here on the McGill campus. 2:20 left here in the third. 40 seconds left in the power play. McGill looking to just kill out the clock and go to bed with a 2-point victory or 2 points in their back pocket over the Nipissing Lakers. Gervais Chouinard behind the net. Perron will flip it up and slice it down into Nipissing territory, but we can still see that the trash talking going on back and forth between both schools. Neil Prokop giving a big hit, and we'll see what the call is, but Prokop will definitely be going to the penalty box, and we can tell that both teams have become very testy with each other. We'll see what number that is. We can't tell with his jersey just rolled up on the back of him. It looks like it appears it is and you can see Bailey giving it to Neil Prokop right now, but we can't tell what number that is yet. But most certainly that was a big hit, though, from Neil Prokop that sent him to the penalty box. Matt Patton. It is indeed Matt Patton, the top goal scorer for Nipissing, who took the big hit from Neil Prokop, the fourth-year player from Woodstock, Ontario, played his OHL hockey with the Erie Otters, and he will go off. And that, it appears, will be the night for him. And we'll see what the ramification is now, if Nipissing will look to get back retribution against McGill in that play. But we look at the last couple minutes here, Brent. It has been very chippy from both schools. And it kind of culminated with that big hit from Neil Prokop, who has been sent to the penalty box for 2 minutes. So a two-minute interference call. McGill will be down a man here as Demon Rose will come off the ice and go off quickly. Nipissing up ahead now. Shot by Bailey, wide of the net. Bailey with possession, can't retain it. Kept in by Nipissing. Inside a minute 20 left, shot wide of the net again. Shannon will keep it in. Down low is Bailey. He can't hold it into Campbell. Harassed by Bernard. Loose puck, flipped in front of the net. Shannon shoots, saved by Gervais Chouinard, and he has seen it very easily today with a minute and 11 seconds left here in the third period. With a minute and 11 seconds left here, a minute 22 left in the power play for Nipissing. They've been powerless in terms of their production. Smith with the lone goal by their attack. Puck cleared away as Raymond will fight for it down. Rink-wide pass to Campbell. Campbell over the blue line. Inside a minute now in the third period. Cleared away by McGill. McGill will get the 2 points in the back pocket and will now focus up for Laurentian. Puck still in their zone. McDowell to Campbell. Campbell being harassed by Boutte. Boutte gets it down low to McDowell. Big hit by number five for McGill. Francis Lambert-Lamé as he got McDowell on the end of that hit. Easy save for Jacob Gervais-Chouinard, but right now the boom is being laid by the McGill on two players, two of the top 10 players for Nipissing, as Jimmy McDowell took the big hit from Francis Lambert-Lamé from St-Eustache, Quebec. The education major just gave an education on that big hit right now. Let's put it that way. But with 30 points, 5 seconds left here, we'll see if McGill can come away unscathed and come away with the 2 points, which they will. Mitchell cannot keep it in as it is offside here. Stay tuned for the Ye Olde Orchard postgame show as Brent and I will recap the entire game and get you geared up for the weekend ahead as McGill, with a convincing win over the Nipissing Lakers, they'll take on the Laurentian Voyageurs tomorrow night here at McConnell Arena, homecoming weekend. McGill with a strong home victory, only 2 losses last year in their home slate, 12 wins, so they are now on their way to their first win of the season with 15 seconds left here. We'll let the crowd take over for the last 10 seconds of this hockey game here on SSN Canada. Offside, so we'll wait for the crowd to come back in here. A little delay, 8.6 seconds left here, but we'll let the crowd carry the way here as McGill will get their first home victory of the year, but a convincing performance nonetheless here for this Redmen team. .6 seconds left here. We will let the crowd take over. And without that, the crowd did take over in terms of the roaring, but right now a little fisticuffs, a little chippiness as Doug Harvey, my apologies, gave a little chip shot, and away we go. Fight's going to break out. Harvey's fighting. We can't tell which number that is for McGill. Laporte. Laporte and Harvey. Harvey getting a couple rights in. Laporte falls down, and they will stop the fight there as Matt Harvey, or Doug Harvey, my apologies, and Laporte end off the game on a fight here. And the trash talk is still going on between both teams here, and you can see the referee coming just in front of Neil Prokop, but waiting for him to get clearance to come across the rink here. So not the way you want to end off with the sportsmanship here, but nonetheless though, the trash talking has begun and it won't end. They will play each other next Friday in Nipissing. And the intensity has picked up. It's definitely picked up here, Brent. It's October hockey, but it feels like it's March playoffs right now. And McGill waiting for the visitors to leave the ice to give the home crowd a little salute. And you can still see the trash talking still being jibber-jabbered between both schools, even the coaches getting involved for both teams. And you can see Holowenko not leaving the ice very easily as he is giving his two cents right now. And the home crowd gives a nice salute to the McGill Redmen, and McGill will go to center ice and salute the home crowd on a convincing 8-1 victory over the Nipissing Lakers. Here are the three stars. So there you have it, McNichol, the number one star of the game as the number one line starred in the entire game. They did a fantastic job. And stay tuned for the Ye Olde Orchard post-game show as Brent and I will go over the entire game and get you geared up for the weekend as McGill wins 8-1 over the Nipissing Lakers. They'll take on the Laurentian Voyageurs tomorrow night here at McGill at the McConnell Arena homecoming weekend here. And Brent, when we look at this game from start to finish, it was a convincing victory for the McGill Redmen. They did not look back, no hesitation whatsoever. They took it to the Lakers and came away with an 8-1 victory. When you look at the goaltending, of course, Jacob Gervais-Renard had a great game. Pretty easy game, not much action for him except for the one goal he gave up in the second period to Smith. But he looked very cool and relaxed out there, not hesitating at all on any shot that came at him or any pressure from the Laker attack. When you look at Nipissing, it seemed like they were overmatched in all three facets, power play, penalty kill, and 5-on-5. It seemed like they never got on track. And you could sort of see that the young, inexperienced Laker team playing a well-vested veteran team like McGill, no match at all in terms of the player comparison. Talk about growing up, Sam Lebrecht, the Granby, Quebec native, replacing Ryan McKiernan. You can't replace a legend like McKiernan, who was fantastic throughout his McGill career, as Coach Novus, or Coach Novus mentioned to us during the week here. But Lebrecht, two gorgeous goals, and his play in both ends was remarkable for this McGill team. All four lines rolled in and rolled out. They were smooth production from all four lines. Number one line, Dalil Oud, Cedric McNichol, and David Rose. Those three guys had 5 points in the first period alone. They were fantastic. this game, it was from start to finish McGill domination here, but we look ahead against the Laurentian Voyageurs tomorrow night. And they come into town, and they will play McGill. Obviously, McGill will have to go through these back-to-backs for the second team that they'll play the back-to-back, and will have the night off, essentially. How important is it for McGill to get off to a fast start tomorrow, like they did tonight against Nipissing, tomorrow against Laurent? And, of course, they will play these two aforementioned teams, Nipissing and Laurentian, on the road next week as they will head out to deep, deep Ontario to play these two teams on the road as they will go to Nipissing next Friday night and then play Laurentian the following Saturday night on October 25th here. A big thank you to Varsity 515. Stop wasting time on classifieds. Excellent and student living. Varsity 515, Yield Orchard, with many ranges from scotches to 18 beers on tap, butter chicken and wings. Orchard is the place to be. Ye Old Orchard Pub, Domino's Pizza. Go online, domino's.ca, and order yourself a nice pizza for homecoming weekend. Redbird Sports Shop. Get all your swag at Redbird Sports Shop. The Montreal Gazette. Go online, montrealgazette.com, to get your latest news in and around the world. montrealgazette.com. Molson X, a proud sponsor of Subway. Think fresh, eat fresh. Subway, a proud sponsor of McGill Athletics. And don't forget, Milk to Go, Saputo, and the fact that these guys are all proud sponsors of McGill Athletics, we thank them for their support for McGill Athletics, for the Marlins, and for the Redmen. So a reminder, SSN Canada, stay tuned to it all weekend long. We'll have the McGill-Redmen football game against Sherbrooke tomorrow at 1 o'clock, 12:55 pregame thoughts. And then we'll have the men's and women's soccer game Sunday afternoon, 4 p.m., Graham Naismith with the men's call. And I'll have the women's call at 6 p.m. against the Carabin de Montréal, as it is homecoming weekend here. Redbird Classic going on, so if you're not watching the game, come on by to the McGill campus for some great sports all around, men's and women's. Brent, thank you very much. Good job by you. And our entire staff that helped out, our production team that got this rolling here, we thank them for their help and support. So on behalf of Brent Bach and Mokon and the entire SSN staff, we wish you a good evening. And we'll be back here at 12:55 for the Adidas pregame thoughts for McGill and Sherbrooke men's football tomorrow at 1 p.m. on the Hill at Percival Molson Stadium. Good night from McConnell Arena. McGill wins 8-1.